saying? Check this out. The sun went down when I hit Slauson. On my way to the strip, now I'm just flossing. Checking my rear view, cause niggas they will do jack moves. Black fools, cause I smack fools. Trying to set me up for a 211. Fuck around and get caught up in a 187. But I don't represent no gangbang. Some niggas like lynching, but I just watch them hang. So on and so on, why don't you let me roll on? I remember back in the days when I used to have to get my stroll on. Did nobody wanna speak? Now everybody peeping out the window when they hear me beating up the street. Is it Dre? Is it Dre? That's what they say every single motherfucking day. Yo, but I ain't tripping, I'm just kicking it. While my D's keep spinning and these hoes keep grinning, I'll be
rolling in my 6-4.
What everybody's saying? Hell yeah. What everybody's saying?
That was Dr. Dre with Let Me Ride. And, you know, I'm going to keep this little smooth vibe going right now. We got some rapping Forte. Shout out to Uncle Forte, by the way. This is one of my favorite songs of his. It's called I'll Be Around. He actually sampled the I'll Be Around from that old group, The Spinners, back in the day. He sampled their hook, threw it on this shit. Fucking great message behind the song. You know, it's all about loyalty and staying true to who you are and staying true to your friends, man. Like, you know, don't let, for all you artists out there that are coming up and shit and all everyone coming up in the industry, don't let this shit fog your vision of who's really down for you, though. Because at the end of the day, the people who were there for you before you became famous are the ones who you really need to fucking focus on. Real shit. Like, you know, y'all see what I got going on with a little fame I got, a little bit of fame and shit, but at the same time, I'm still going down to fucking Cal Expo and shit this weekend, or not this weekend, but the weekend of the 20th, April 20th, to go hang out with a friend of mine I've known since fucking high school for his wedding. Shout out to Big Red, by the way, getting married. Big congratulations to the homie Big Red. That's what I mean, man. Don't forget about where you came from, because you know what? At the end of the day, I don't give a fuck if I got $1 million coming to me tomorrow and I go hang out and smoke weed with fucking ASAP Rocky and all the celebrities and shit. Fuck it. I'm still going to go down to my hometown, kick it with the same people on the same block, smoke the same fucking blunts. And you know what? I'm always going to be down with those people. That's how you got to do. You always got to stay down for those who are down for you. That's a little bit what this song's about. It's called I'll Be Around. Check it out.
Rack Top Records, may I help you?
Can I speak to folk?
One moment, please. He's around.
Yo, what's up? What's up, folk? Man, I know you finished that cut for the radio.
As a matter of fact, Fly, I just finished it, baby boy. Don't worry about nothing. I'll be around.
On tour with my homie Young Fly, even I'll be sure never hesitate to call me after I'm done, cause homie I'm real and always true to my loved ones. Too many wakes and funerals full of tears. You say there's something on your mind, well hey, I'm all ears, cause ain't nobody thinking about the phone, they're just choosing it. A lot of my homies stuck in the pen for life of losing it. Call up your folks, you keep thinking about home. Recorder keeps repeating, there's a block on the phone, and all this is enough to make a brother's nerves bad. Reminds me of a situation that I once had. Spent this, endless, relentless, tremendous. Women on my jacket, don't nobody mind their business. He say, she say, throwing salt about. And choose to talk about you, cause there's nothing else to talk about. Talk about the shit.
prepared. Fools be huffing and puffing, don't wanna see me about nothing, I'm down. And if you ever need me fly, I'll be around. I'll be around. You know I love you, boy. Life ain't based on peaches and cream. This new generation holds a whole lot of dreams. Future doctors, producers, and mothers. The list goes on, but now we're killing our brothers. And if we're killing our brothers, that means we're killing our own kind. As kids are watching, now it goes through their mind. Rat-a-tat-tat, cause you got a gat, and they want a gat. You living like that? But I'm not surprised. Just look what's televised. You shouldn't take a bullet for a brother to realize. We running in hard heads, they running in hot lead. They visit a deathbed. I feel that's enough said. Enough is enough. Too much crime building. No, I'm not a role model, but I think of the children. They hang out late night, cause they feel that's right. To watch the gunplay, a bloody street fight. So I'ma be around with a funky rap, G. I know how it is, and hopefully you feel me. Cause where I come from, we rap the tight beats. And if you don't hustle, that's a day you don't eat. Moms ain't cooking, she worked a week straight. If anything, she's the one deserves a hot plate. The ghetto ain't nothing to dream about. Trying to get out, now that's something to think about. Fools might disagree, but I'ma stay sucker free. Man, I'm so black and so strong, they can't fade me. Blacks are black's worst enemy, there's still no remedy. You got me full grips, till you call yourself kin to me? Jealousy, envy, I see it in your eyes. Tell me what's wrong with seeing a black man rise. I keep it funky, it's pretty hard to miss it. Now it isn't, not explicit. A message for the mind and the moral for statistics. So I'm doing what we call a roll call. Calling out the ones who want rap to take a downfall. I spit the street life, and then I go underground. Silly, it's called versatility, and I'll be around.
Whenever you call me, I'll be there.
Yeah, all you busters. Y'all was down, but I'll be around.
That was Rapping Forte with I'll Be Around. Big shout out to Uncle Forte. That's an artist that I'm really glad I got the chance to, you know, meet and work with and get to know. Be trying to get him on the show actually pretty soon. Just talked to him not too long ago, so I'm going to try and get him on the show with us. But, so I decided, because I get bored sometimes, and I'm like, you know what, I'm sure the listeners kind of get bored of some same old shit too. Let me add something new to the mix. So we added prank calls to the show format, and I posted on Instagram just now. I did post on my Facebook earlier, for those of you lucky enough to have me on Facebook. I did post on my Facebook earlier as well. If you guys want me to prank call your friends, hit me up. Fucking, you can hit me up on Instagram, the_CEO_official. Send me a little info on them, the phone number, name. We'll get it cracking. I was very proud of the results. You guys are evil motherfuckers, man. Y'all really are. I mean, people were giving me so many different phone numbers and information on people. So, I did one today. We're going to go ahead and play this one that I did. This is, we called this lady Laura Cantrell. And here's how that call went.
Yes, is Laura Cantrell available?
This is her.
Hi, Laura. This is Dr. Jameson calling from Kaiser Permanente. How are you doing today?
From where?
Kaiser Permanente Medical Facility.
Oh.
Is this a good time to speak, ma'am? Do you have a minute?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, now we went over your recent lab results here. Something we weren't looking for actually popped up. That's why I wanted to make sure it was a good time to speak. Now, ma'am, when was the last time you were sexually active without protection? I know it's kind of a personal question, but just looking at these lab results.
It's really bad or something?
What's that?
Is this really bad or something?
It could be if it goes untreated.
Oh, so it's treatable? Okay.
It is treatable. I mean, you're always going to have it, but it's treatable. You just don't want it to go untreated. Now,
what is it?
Well, that's what I wanted to get into. First, I just needed to make sure. Now, when was the last time you would say that you were sexually active?
January.
Need to make sure this is January. And was
what
that
is
with
it?
Protection?
What
with
is
not
it?
Protection?
Sir, can you just tell me you're freaking me out?
I'm sorry? You say turkey?
Can you just tell me what it is? You're freaking me out.
Oh, ma'am, don't freak out. I mean, it just is a couple procedures that would clear this up. It will at least clear it up for right now. You will have to, we'll give you some information when you come in, a pamphlet on how to really treat this and who you need to make some phone calls to.
Okay, what is it, please? You're freaking
me
the fuck out. You're freaking me the fuck out.
No, ma'am, if you're going to use language like that, I'm not going to actually speak to you. You can go with this untreated in your vagina to call out on the street.
I have really bad anxiety.
Okay, well, ma'am, now, when you said in January, was that with a random partner? Was that with?
No.
No? And were you using protection
boyfriend.
At the time? Your boyfriend.
No,
oh.
It was my boyfriend.
You guys definitely need to have a talk, man, because this isn't good. This isn't something you would get normally unless you were sleeping around with random people.
Okay, what is it, sir?
I'm sorry?
What is it?
Well, it's a STD of sorts that, you know, we haven't really seen a whole lot of nowadays. Well, you did contract the HIV virus, ma'am, but not.
What?
I mean, like I said, it's not like it was in the 90s. You know, everyone freaks out over it nowadays, but it's not like it was in the 90s, ma'am. I promise you that.
What
you know,
is
there
it?
Are things we could do to treat it, ma'am. I do have one thing to tell you. Calm down. This is actually the CEO of the West Coast. You're on CEO Radio right now. How are you doing today?
What?
A friend of yours had sent us in your number, told us to give you a call, message you a little bit. This is the CEO show on CEO Radio. Sorry
about
that, ma'am.
This is not funny at all. This is fucking terrible. I have a newborn baby. I have a newborn baby. What is wrong with you?
Well, you know, I wish you and your baby the greatest success, and, you know, I wish you and your boyfriend the greatest success. You have a great day, ma'am. Thanks for tuning in to CEO Radio.
I fucking laugh every time I hear that shit. This broad really thought she had AIDS. Like, she really thought she got it. She got that shit. Now, to the people listening, if you get a random call, what are the odds that someone's going to call you and you're actually going to be waiting on lab results for an STD or whatever? Because I said, we got your recent lab results and she went right with it. I knew nothing about this chick other than her name and her phone number. And the fact she lived in California where the Kaiser Permanente Hospital is. I knew nothing about this woman.